Welcome. Today we'll take a look at the X-Plane 12.1.2 beta update, which includes scenery at the Princess Juliana International Airport on the Caribbean island of Sint Maarten. The rain on the runway looks incredible. We'll take off from runway 10 and then fly the Juliana 2 departure to Juice. The departure is an interesting one, which includes flying part of an arc on the way to Juice. We'll use the autopilot and monitor the departure. As we are returning to land, let's open the speed window and fly at 220 knots. This will slow things down and give us time to set up for the approach. Once the gear and flaps are retracted, the after takeoff flow is performed. With two crew, the pilot monitoring would do this, then follow up with the checklist. The setup for a non-ILS approach is very similar with some additions. As always, we create a 2-mile ring around the final approach fix for situational awareness. We'll select an approach reference speed for flaps 40. Flaps 40 will reduce the approach speed and landing distance required. Here's a difference to an ILS on prog page 4. Enter a value of 125 feet for the vertical RNP if there isn't a value on the chart. On prog page, then nav status page 2, VOR update would be turned off in the real aircraft. The minimum descent altitude on this approach is 700 feet. We'll convert that to a derived decision altitude by adding 50 feet, so our mints are 750 feet. This is because we won't be leveling off, and the extra 50 feet prevents us undershooting the MDA if we go missed. Let's change the altitude at the final approach fix, LASER, to 1,700 feet, instead of at or above. This is good practice, so VNAV creates a path to the exact altitude. With standing water on the runway, let's select Autobrakes Level 3. We've just been given a shortcut from D237L to Avaki. As we were previously cleared for the RNAV 10 approach, 800 was set on the MCP. This is our derived decision altitude of 750 feet, rounded up to the next 100 feet. We're descending on the VNAV path. It shows we are above the path, so can increase drag by adding flaps, and could also use the flight spoilers to increase our rate of descent. When we're 300 feet below the missed approach altitude, we can set it. It's a little tricky to set in the sim with the turbulence. With the runway in sight, we're able to continue descending. The airport scenery is very realistic. We hope you enjoyed this look at the enhanced scenery in the beta update, as well as demonstration of the departure and RNAV approach. Please click like if you found it of interest, and please subscribe to learn of our future videos. Thank you.